Ito ang AceFast T8. In this video, gagawa natin ang unboxing and first impressions itong TWS Bluetooth earbuds na ito. Kaya tara, pag-usapan natin. By the way, disclaimer lang, this product pala ay sent to me for review by the brand AceFast mismo. Kaso I am not paid nor sponsored to make this review. Kaya maasahan nyo na you will be having an objective and honest review similar naman sa lahat ng videos ko. Anyways, ayun lang naman. So for the second time, tara, pag-usapan natin. So simulan natin sa mismong box. So pagdating sa box itself, I can say naman na it looks presentable. Especially yung size ng box ay hindi normally yung napapansin natin specifically sa mga Bluetooth earbuds. Since first of all, maliit sila and I think there's no practical reason kung bakit kailangan ng malaking box similar sa mga AirPods. Kaso for these earbuds, may importante at napaka-surprising na reason kung bakit ganito kalaki yung box. And trust me, you'll be surprised kung bakit nasasabihin ko sa inyo mamaya. So moving on sa front part ng box, as you can tell, we are blasted with overwhelming information about the earbuds. So ilan dito ay syempre yung mismong illustration ng earbuds. Tapos we have the LED stereoscopic digital display, which basically means that we can see the battery percentage ng mismong earbuds sa mismong earbuds case natin. Tapos we have more information here sa baba na pag-usapan natin some of it later. Sa left side naman, we will be seeing more informations to describe yung mismong earbuds. Like firstly, we have exquisite appearance, which I can agree on kasi nakita ko na at nagagamit ko na yung mismong earbuds na makikita nyo rin later. Tapos we have perfect sound, comfortable to wear, and touch control na pag-usapan natin later. So abang nyo lang. So sa right side, same lang din naman, more informations to describe yung mismong earbuds. Moreover, sa back part naman, we have more informations na pag-usapan natin later. Some of it yung mga bagay na I find important. So yun, anyways, that's pretty much about this box. Kaya huwag na tayo magpatumpik-tumpik pa. Tara, at i-unbox na natin. So yun, mabilis sa summary lang tayo sa mga included na mismong earbuds natin. So first we have the, wait lang, kinukuha ko lang. We have the case and yung mismong lanyard natin na may kasama pang silicone ear tips na may dedicated case pa. And that's practically the main reason kung bakit kailangan malaki yung box kasi they need to insert these materials pa or mga inclusions pa. Actually, share ko lang, no, I have never seen an earbuds na may kasama ng case and lanyard pati itong silicone ear tips na may dedicated case inserted sa box mismo. So kudos to AceFast for adding this material. So that's nice. Tapos next naman, we have a pamphlet about the products na binibenta ng AceFast. So we have, check natin. May mga binibenta sila mga power banks, charger, and yung mismong cord. So that's nice. Tapos kung balak nyo bumili nito, you can pick from 6 different colors. So we have Lotus Pink, Alfalfa Purple, Mint Green, Ice Blue, Bright Black, and White Moon. And yung kinawa ko guys is yung mismong White Moon kasi para similar ng color sa iPhone. Tanggalin ko lang sa case guys. Para similar sa color ng iPhone XR ko. So that's nice for the third time. Tapos we have the charging cord and the quick startup guide. At panghuli syempre, we have the AceFast T8. So pagdating sa mismong design, unang pansin ko dito, unang kita ko sa AceFast T8, napansin ko na it looks futuristic and appealing. Kumbaga, visualize nyo to. Try to compare Apple sa mga Android products or at least sa mga phones. For a tech reviewer or anyone, iisipin natin na when we see an Apple product or at least iPhones, generally maiisip natin na they're simple but elegant and decent looking or classy looking. Kahit sa mga flagship Android phones, elegant din, kaso nga lang, they are more flashy, extravagant, and grandiose. At ganun yung tingin ko sa AceFast T8. We have a futuristic appeal na may clear crystal appearance at talagang we can directly the main board of the charging case. Unlike sa mga AirPods ko na it's kinda really simple and there's not much into it. Actually, napansin ko na the AceFast T8 kinda resembles the Nothing earbuds and Nothing phone na may transparent design. So moving on sa front part ng earbuds, we have the battery indicator for the case and the earbuds themselves. And that for me is really helpful kasi pwede kong makita yung battery percentage on the spot. Hindi katulad sa mga AirPods, kailangan ko pang bunutin yung phone ko just to check the battery percentage na mismong AirPods natin. At yung feature na pinaka nagustuhan ko about these earbuds is yung lighting mismo. So pag tinanggal natin yung mga earbuds, eka focus lang natin sa camera, pag tinanggal yung mismong earbuds, magkakaroon siya ng lighting effect guys. So, di ata masyado kita kasi medyo maliwanag, but I'll be playing a video guys showing the lighting effect ng mismong earbuds natin. And by that aspect, talaga nakakapagbigay siya ng gaming or futuristic vibe, so that's nice. By the way, magnetic pala yung pagdikit ng mismong charging case or baliktad, pagdikit ng mismong earbuds sa charging case, so assured na hindi siya basta-basta babagsak or mahuhulog or matatanggal, so that's nice. So moving on sa back part naman, we have the AceFast logo and some informations about the earbuds, and lastly, we have the charging port. Pagdating sa earbuds, same lang din, transparent and clear in design. Tapos we have the silicone ear tips na similar sa mga AirPods Pros. And that for me is really helpful, especially whenever I work out or nagjo-jogging ako kasi it prevents the earbuds to fall out of my ear. Though may kasama siyang mga silicone ear tips, but for me yung mismong built-in na silicone ear tips from these earbuds is sakto-sakto lang sa ear ko. or sa ears ko. And by the way, the Ace Fast T8 pala has some touch gestures or touch controls na similar sa mga AirPods. So we have double tap to play or pause, tapos triple tap naman to move sa next song or next video. At may volume control din pala to, but for me napansin ko na medyo responsive siya, so ayun. But still, it works naman guys anyway, so that's nice. So moving on, we have a plastic build na may 47 grams in terms of weight. And yes, magaan siya, and yun yung bagay na gusto ko sa isang earbuds. Kaso nga lang, napansin ko na pag nabagsak ko to, most likely doon sa possibility na pwede mabagsak or mabasag to. So ayun, ingat-ingat na lang. Although on the flip side, these earbuds pala is splash resistant, IPX4 to be specific. But for me guys, palagi ko sinasabi sa mga videos ko, it's better to be safe than sorry, so that's nice. So to connect this earbuds sa phone natin, very simple lang. Go to settings, open Bluetooth, and connect to Ace Fast T8. And by that, connected na agad yung mismong earbuds natin sa phone natin ng mabilis lang, so that's nice. Anyway, by means sa mismong sound quality, for me, it's fine lang. I can say naman na it's decent but not that great nor superior quality compared sa mga higher-end TWS earbuds. Don't get me wrong, di siya tunog lata or mumurahin by any means. It's just that I was kinda expecting more for these earbuds kasi medyo may kamahalan yung price nito. Tinry ko siya actually compare sa AirPods Pro second generation ko na premium copy, and napansin ko, the quality difference is really apparent. In basic terms, mas rich and crisp or generally mas mabass yung output ng AirPods Pro second generation premium copy. Well, syempre, let's give credit kasi kahit pa paano, nakapag-contribute dito yung spatial audio and noise control. Sa Ace Fast T8 naman, to be fair, malinaw at maganda naman yung audio quality. Kaso, not to the point I can consider it as professional as what they claim. So in simple terms, demo ko sa inyo, yung bass coming out from the Ace Fast T8 is pa ganito. Bug, 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 bug. Tapos sa AirPods Pro to premium copy, ganito naman. Bug, bug, bug. Gets ba guys? Parang ganun. Kumbaga kapag you're listening to music gamit yung mismong AirPods Pro second generation premium copy, talaga mas na-resonate yung bass niya compared sa Ace Fast T8. By the way, one major advantage na napansin ko sa Ace Fast T8 compared sa mga other premium copies na AirPods na nagamit ko before, medyo mas malala yung latency nila compared sa Ace Fast T8. Basically, sa Ace Fast T8, mapag-gaming man yan, talagang tugma or sabay yung audio sa bosses or actions ng game natin or synced yung tunog. Kahit pagdating sa social media platforms, kung gaano ka-sync yung audio output kapag walang earbuds, ganun din yung output kapag naka-earbuds tayo, so that's nice. So next naman, test out natin yung quality coming from this Ace Fast T8, so kukonek ko muna siya sa phone ko and go to voice memos. Pinig niyo ba yun guys? Nag-tin-tin. Ganun yung sound niya pag nilalagay ko yung earbuds. But anyways, kukunin ko naman siya sa iPhone 11 ko. So let's go to voice memos muna. Yo, what's up, Ezek here. So I'm currently testing out the Ace Fast T8. Yung ito yung gamit ko yung microphone niya. So ito yung sound quality. So currently yung electric fan is yung number 1. So medyo malayo siya sa akin. But ito yung sound quality guys. Pinig ba yung hangin electric fan? So sound test, mic test, 1, 2, 3. Sound test, mic test, 1, 2, 3. Kamusta yung quality? So sa battery naman, pagdating sa specs, so tanggalin ko muna itong earbuds ko. Babalik ko lang sa case. So ASMR muna tayo guys. Ayan. That's nice. Anyways, let's get the box first para makita ko yung specs ng mismong earbuds natin. So na yun. So yung headset or earbuds natin has 45 mAh. Tapos yung case naman mismo, yung charging case, has 480 mAh. By means of charging time naman, about 1 hour for the charging time ng headset, tapos 1.5 hours for the charging case. By means of the usage time or kung ilang hours pwede natin magamit yung mismong earbuds natin, sabi sa box, about 7 hours for the headset working time and about 30 hours for the total working time. Kaso I can't really tell pa or I can't really verify pa kung totoo yun or ganun din sa experience ko kasi this is just a first impression pa lang. I'll update na lang sa comment section below or sa description box about my experience in terms of battery and or whatnot or sa mga other informations about these earbuds or possibly kapag madami interested or madami nag-request, I'll be making a full in-depth review ng earbuds na to na Ace Fast T8, so that's nice, abang nila. So guys, that's pretty much about this product, the Ace Fast T8. If gusto nyo bumili, kindly check the description box or the comment section below. Once again, big thanks to Ace Fast for sending this to me for review, so that's nice for the third time. So guys, if you learned something from this video, don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe on this YouTube channel, so thank you very much. So guys, that's been it, catch you in the next one. Peace and that's nice.